So the themes in the first episode were meant to simply get some bearings within placements and chart themes. But now, we're going to get a little deeper, a little trippier, and a little more esoteric.
The nodes and MCIC are some of my favorite astrology placements, as they really provide the metaphysical, energetic, and thematic map in regards to life path and purpose type energies, while at the same time threading in past life, karma, and energies that have already been experienced and mastered. The flow of that is to use energy inherent to you as a core competency with which to move through and embody the lessons and challenges of this lifetime. So bear with me in this episode, as these placements have multiple dynamics at play, and since I'm reading this chart from both a band collective as well as an individual human aspect, it's a little dense, but in my opinion, totally worth the analysis. In astrology, the South Node represents energies in your field that you come into this life incarnation already having experienced. It's attached to past lives, karmic cycles, and familiar patterns. For this chart, South Node is at 8 degrees Leo in the 9th house. So breaking down the astrology, Leo brings brave and fiery lion energy to the equation. Leo is all about creativity, self-expression, heart-centered passion, joy, and laughter. It provides really beautiful inner child vibes, balanced with a fierce intensity to be comfortable in the spotlight. Leo as a fire sign is also a beacon. Like a lion in the animal kingdom, its energy is meant to lead the pack. So Leo naturally garners a lot of attention.
First, I want to look at the karmic cycles aspect of the South Node. In surface astrology, people tend to associate Leo as being egotistical or kind of full of themselves. It's true, Leos tend to draw attention effortlessly. But the point of Leo naturally attracting attention isn't to be self-serving and ego-driven, but rather to serve as a beacon of fierce passion, being the living example of how to naturally drive actions from the passion of our hearts, yet in a playful and dynamic kind of way. I love Leo energy personally. Given that aspect, it's worth mentioning that the unconscious side of Leo is self-serving, ego-driven vanity. Because Leo naturally feels comfortable in the spotlight, it can easily get lost in the act of garnering attention and glamour, causing it to lose sight of the joy, laughter, and heart-based creativity its energy is meant to represent. That's the natural polarity of big Leo energy and kind of where it gets its, you know, traditional MO of being egotistical.
Coming into this life with a South Node Leo indicates these energy patterns being highlighted in previous incarnated experiences. It's the whole Spider-Man thing of with great power comes great responsibility. So it's here that we can pick up on some threads of past life karmic patterning where perhaps one or all of the band members, or perhaps even a single person that was a collective energetic representation of the band, either got lost in egoic ventures, potentially got steamrolled by the egoic endeavors of another, and chose ultimately not to follow their heart because of it. Basically, this life is a chance at redemption and brings a natural mastery of this energy. Now, I'm going to say this from my personal perspective here, but I think a lot of us would agree. If you've been lucky enough to meet the guys, they've literally mastered being as humble as possible given their rock star status. Within the spectrum of accomplishments, they're one of the most accessible bands of their size. And although Nick and Peanut and Essay make themselves a bit more visible than like Tim or Chad, no individual member seems to deem themselves truly more important than another. Even if you disagree regarding their personalities, you can see it in the way they write their music together and collaborate, and the way they integrate and rotate how the set lists are written. Ultimately, they are a pack, and they know it. They know they are better together and have very recently demonstrated their ability to put their egos aside in pursuit of the greater good they can offer as a collective. That's like the epitome of healing and redemption of the lower octave of Leo energy. Essentially, this 9 to 5, we go for the high. I think it's really fitting that the moment this band was formed, South Node was in Leo, the fire sign that represents creative expression, in the 9th house of beliefs, philosophies, wisdom, and travel. It can definitely explain the intuitive passion and drive they collectively share for what they do. Leo also brings a lighter energy of laughter and joy, a quintessential cornerstone of the band's brotherhood, amongst themselves, as well as weaved throughout the music and lyrics, and ultimately infused into our community at large. It's a nice combination with the eclectic Gemini sun and a much-needed balance of the Scorpio rising and Capricorn themes of the chart. Furthermore, Leo is ruled by the sun, which represents identity. The fact that they built an identity for the band off the idea of sharing positive vibes at a time where grunge and negativity were the prevalent messages is so fitting of a South Node Leo. Like, they intuitively understood the assignment of Leo, probably without even being fully conscious of it.
Also noteworthy here is that the placement falls at the Saturn degree. While this lends a serious edge of responsibility and commitment to this placement, Saturn also rules leadership, which, yet again, seems very fitting here in combination with the lion archetype. We all know the stories of how determined and committed the band was to succeed in the early days, but it seems here they also had some energetic support and understanding of how to be leaders and drive towards their goals without losing their ideals along the way. That was kind of like inherently built into this collective. It was through standing for something different, being true to their identity, and ultimately believing in themselves that they were able to succeed and forge ahead in such a difficult industry. Ultimately, all South Node energy considered, their ability to embody the lion in a fierce but humble way paid itself off with the really extraordinary and rare life experience of getting to visit the world as rock stars. They don't just deserve this life because of the hard work they put in. They were destined for it.
Now, the IC represents what helps you feel nurtured, safe, and comfortable. Similar to the nodes, it can also represent energies you've experienced or mastered in previous lifetimes, and unlock karmic and ancestral patterns as well. It connects the third house of the mind, thoughts, and communication with the fourth house of family, self-care, comfort, and home. 311's IC is at 11 degrees Pisces. Pisces is the last sign of the zodiac, representing spirituality itself, compassion, empathy, and healing. It's highly intuitive, emotionally driven, and essentially feeds off vibes and the things that can't be seen in physical reality. So a Pisces IC is pretty dope placement and very fitting for the band. Ruled by Neptune, this placement has a high level of comfort and mastery around healing and transcendence. And at the moon degree, it naturally taps into the emotional flow to do so. I mean, there are so many ways we can analyze and interpret this, but in the interest of time, it's really a beautiful placement that highlights the band's ability to connect with us all through the unseen frequency embedded within the music itself. Tapping into this frequency and using it as a tool with which to expand our emotional capacity and ability to spread positivity, empathy, and deeper levels of conscious healing.
And I mean, if you've listened to this analysis thus far, chances are favorable that you fall somewhere in the gamut of someone who at some point emotionally connected with 311's music. For some, it may be as simple as enjoying the beats and lyrics, but I know for others, especially me, if we're particularly conscious souls out there, I mean, I have legitimately had like out-of-body spiritual experiences from 311's music and at their live show.
I mean, have you ever really tuned into the frequency of Mitt's use of time solo live? I'll preface my next comment by noting I don't drink. I don't do any drugs, party or otherwise, and surprising to most, I don't even smoke weed. 311 Day 2018, I legitimately left my body during Tim's use of time solo. And it wasn't the first time that's happened at a 311 show. I mean, let's look at songs like Inner Light Spectrum, The Continuous Life, Existential Hero, Face in the Wind. I feel like I could spend hours poking at the metaphysical aspects of 311's catalog. And that's just lyrically. And I'm many things, but I am furthest from an expert at musical construction and theory. But I did once have a 3.11 second long conversation with Chad, specifically around the beats incorporated in the music. And he gave nothing away directly, of course, but I'm still convinced that there's purposeful inclusion of solfeggio and binaural healing tones infused into 311's music. If any music expert out there wants to chime in on my theory with some of your own analysis, go right ahead in the comments below or, you know, wherever. Anyway, I feel like a lot of that contributes to why many of us feel so whole again and so healed after a 311 show. It's why so many of us chase that and will go see them 50, 100, 311 times, even when we haven't had a new album in 5 years. It's literally a vibe, our therapy, our family reunion, and a spiritual experience all at once.
Long story short, these guys own this gift and ability so hard. I often wonder how conscious it really is and how much is just channeled through them as individuals, as well as collectively when they come together in unity. But what I can say is there's absolutely no accident that these guys naturally understand at a fundamental core level how to take the vibrational frequency of music and use it for the healing of unity consciousness. The band Collective was literally created with the energetic map to be the cowboy existential hero. That rounds up the energies inherent to the band. So now we're going to look at the other side of the spectrum.
So the North Node is essentially the North Star of the chart. It represents the energies you grow into throughout the course of this incarnation. Some people consider it to be life purpose, and it can certainly point you in the direction that heavily aligns best with what you're here to learn, experience, and give back to others. 311's North Node is 8 degrees Aquarius in the third house. It's funny, but I feel like I can connect very easily with the energies of the nodes of this chart because my own nodes on my chart are in the opposite signs. My South Node in Aqua is my area of expertise, while my North Node Leo in the spotlight is what I'm literally growing into as I create this content for you. Anyway, Aquarius is an air sign that is known to be future-forward, freedom-loving, visionary energy of the zodiac. Aquarian energy is generally collectively driven and innovative, detached from conditioning and easily bored by norms and fitting in. So remember, unlike the South Node, this energy isn't mastered yet, but it's about what's being learned. North Node energy has to be grown into. And damn if our boys understood the assignment. I don't think I need to overly analyze this placement because the music itself tells the story. The band never cared about what was on the radio, and the goal was to be eclectic and innovative. They were never beholden to a specific style or tried to fit into a box. They wanted to create a new box that no one had heard before, and they had to kind of learn that through trial and error. In classic air sign fashion, also consistent with their Gemini sun, they were able to take threads of inspiration from multiple genres and thread it into something visionary. The third house of the chart deals with the energies of thought and communication, which is essentially the vehicle with which they shared their future-forward visionary creations. At the Saturn degree, they remained committed and accountable to their craft and their message. With Uranus, ruler of Aquarius, the road to get here was marked with unexpected twists and turns. Like the RV fire. Like, throughout their 3.5 decades, they've navigated and continue to navigate major changes within the music business. Perhaps the more recent turmoil within the band itself. And if they want to keep going and make it to 40 or 50 years, there will be other unexpected surprises that force them to adapt and transform both individually as people and collectively as a unit. That's what North Node energy is all about. It's not really an end goal, but rather a path of experiences. And embodying a detached, future-forward, freedom-loving mindset is key to their navigation here. We can also note in this section that Timothy Jerome Mahoney is an Aquarius sun. From the outside looking in, if there was ever a band member who seemed detached to his personal rock star fame, it's gotta be Tim. As part of its future-forward vantage point, Aquarius energy is innovative and can be mysterious. Its intuitive connection to energy itself. And I'm pretty convinced that Tim channels the likes of Jerry Garcia and other guitar and existential heroes that he models and looks up to. Like I mentioned earlier, his ability to convey frequency in a way that allows us to embody the messages of music makes him a really powerful channel. And I'm so grateful that in true Aquarius form, he's opened his life to us for our collective benefit. I feel like Mitt is in the category of otherworldly. Like air itself, he's somehow simultaneously both a bridge and a vibe between spirit and earth. Like in the way that his solos can really take you to another dimension. Wherever he's at when he's deep in it, he has the power to bring us there with him. And hopefully many of you have experienced this, but you can literally feel that energy in a Tim hug. Not gonna lie, I've literally dreamed about Tim hugs. They are totally a vibe.
Now moving on to the final placement of today's episode. The MC is about where you fit in among the world around you. It bridges the energy between the ninth house of wisdom, philosophy, travel, beliefs, and the 10th house of legacy, life purpose, structure, masculinity. It can, but doesn't always, represent career and can also represent achievements, ambitions, and basically how your energy assists the world.
311's MC is 11 degrees Virgo. So Virgo is a sign that I would not off the top of my head assume was the MC of this chart. However, as we dig into Virgo's energy, it really all falls into place. An earth sign, Virgo is the fixer energy. It turns wrongs into rights and really embodies presence as an incarnated human. Ruled by Mercury, information, understanding, and communication come very naturally to Virgos. Unlike Mercury's other sign, Gemini, who is heady and utilizes this energy in the mind, Virgos are naturally earthy and can embody information into lived experience more naturally. Basically, information and understanding allow Virgo to help integrate higher frequencies and concepts into the body and into the lived experience. Also noteworthy here, and pretty aligned, is that Chad is 311's Virgo sun. Again, I'm no music expert, but I'm not sure there's an instrument more earthy than the drum. I'm not sure there's a better way to physically embody and add backbone to music than through the drum beat. I'll never forget reading the old Q&A with the band from the late 90s. Someone asked Chad about how to be a good drummer, and his literal response was, "Practice a lot and use a metronome. It'll make you rock like a clock." And I'm not sure there's any response more functionally Virgo than that. Shout out to 311 Archive for having extensive access to a lot of these old bits and pieces that I'm referencing throughout this series. Definitely check out their site, 311archive.com, and follow their socials for awesome 311 content. Chad has been known to be deeply involved with 311 mixing and production of the final track. Virgos can often be perfectionists, and like I mentioned on the last episodes in regards to Scotch, I think it's the subtle addition of sounds and elements that add such depth and allow more of us to connect with the music, and it's really integral in the final release, being truly like works of art. You can tell Chad embodies that naturally in the way he's connected his own drumming to visual artistry. But to have the attention to detail to be able to organize sound in that way too is really so representative of core Virgo energies. So I mean, I don't know, but I believe he's encrypting secrets in the beat of the drum and infusing that into the backbone of 311 music. Receiving messages encoded in rhythm. Now, the collective MC itself. I think overall the meaning of this placement in this chart points to 311's propensity for taking esoteric concepts, packaging them through the frequency of music, and essentially transmitting it to us in a way that we can actually embody and literally dance into our existence. Like, first off, seriously, how fucking cool is that? I think it's a really nice balance to the eclectic Aquarian nature of the music. The ability to take concept, frequency, words, and understanding and package it all into something that's digestible to the masses. And they've literally made it their career and purpose around that. They literally make an instrumental, add a little vocal, take it to the stage, and we dance it into our realities together in unity. The way their energy assists in righting the wrongs of the world is through embodiment of higher concepts and understanding, lifting people up in positivity, teaching the ideals of unity. At the moon degree, this embodiment can be felt emotionally, which allows us to connect to it in even deeper ways. Bringing the sound, the words, the vibrations, all of it, all the way from the ethers of sound and concept and grounding it into us through our human vessels.
So, I mean, in my humble opinion, part of the reason I love concerts so much is the unique presence factor that it brings me. When I'm at a show, I'm there. In the moment. Over those 2 hours, there is nothing else going on in my world. It's pure presence. And that's what makes the live show such an important tool for 311. The symbiotic presence for absorption and digestion of these higher concepts. I could literally cry thinking about how well this band has embodied this placement. And then together in unity, we literally all fucking get down to the ground. So simple yet profound. In the now, it's literally why they're here. It's time to get down to the ground. So simple yet profound. In the now, it's why we're collective capacity of this band and the importance of its message of unity is literally written in the stars. Thank you so much for watching this episode. I hope the information contained here resonated with you as much as it did with me. I hope it offered some additional depth and insight into our favorite band. The series was so much fun to make. If you enjoyed this content and would like to support my continued journey of guiding others, please check out the merch link in comments below.
The design of this merch has elements embedded directly from this analysis. So not only does it look cool and you'd be repping our favorite band, but it connects directly to the energetic map of the band itself. As a Scorpio rising, your purchase directly helps support my aligned mission of transformation and guidance as a service to others. Basically, your support allows me to keep doing what I'm doing.
Hopefully this series gave you a feel for how I read charts and how the information from your own chart could potentially help you identify and approach strengths and patterns within your own life. The chart is really here to help us navigate our way through this existence, and I'd love to be able to help and guide you through it.
If you're interested in your own energy analysis and guidance sessions, please reach out directly via DM or email. For astrology-inspired merch, visit sunmoonrisingshop.com. For daily content linking the astrology to aspects of grounded healing and real-life application, follow me on Instagram at sun.moon.rising.bliss. Or for 311 content, my personal Instagram, Unity Grassroots. Finally, for more readings, the rest of this series, and for guided meditations that help wire in energies like this, comment, like, subscribe to this channel. Once again, sending out gratitude for any support you'd like to offer for alignment with my greater mission of service to others. Thanks for listening, believing in me, and having an open mind and an open heart. Much love, and let it flow, because it won't stop.